morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tanya Singh and I will be speaking for the motion. And the motion for the house is I am happy that I am co-founder. The main theme of my argument will be development, and I will be talking about development in technology, health and economic development. Ladies and gentlemen, our first sector is technology. Technology has helped improve communication. There is no longer a constraint in communication. I can ping you in a second and you will reply in another minute. There is no distance in communication, ladies and gentlemen. Earlier, communication would take days, weeks, maybe, you know, almost a month to send a letter from here to there. But today, I just send you a message and you know what is happening in hardly a minute. Ladies and gentlemen, it has reduced proximity between two people. A grandmother sitting in India can look at her granddaughter sitting in the US. I can talk to my father who is fighting on the at the battlefront, ladies and gentlemen. It has reduced proximity. Dissemination of information, ladies and gentlemen, whether spreading information, broadcasting news, or sharing knowledge, technology has made faster, easier, and smarter. Ladies and gentlemen, in healthcare, medical devices help people who are not, who have chronological diseases or have disabled or are disabled. For example, we all know Stephen Hawking, the famous physicist. He is surviving only because of technological developments in healthcare, ladies and gentlemen. He speaks through a vocal synthesizer. Now imagine, if he was dead, if he was not able to speak, we wouldn't know the brief history of time. In education, ladies and gentlemen, the student-teacher distance is reduced. The teachers can use aids to help students, ladies and gentlemen, and the interest of students is maintained, and there is instant access to material. I come to the head now. In general, the life expectancy in earlier 20th century was just 30 to 45 years, and now it has gone up to 67 years, ladies and gentlemen. Imagine, you were dying in 30 to 45 years. Now our life only begins in 30 to 45 years. That is the peak in our life. And there was a time when we were dying in 30 to 45 years, ladies and gentlemen. The infant mortality rate in 1950 to 55 was 152, and it has now come down to 47 in 2005-2007. You know, imagine the number of children who were dying. Imagine. That has reduced by such a lot. Diseases like smallpox and plague have been eradicated. The bubonic plague almost wiped out the whole of Europe, and is now eradicated. We do not have the fear of that disease anymore. Even if there are disease, new diseases such as AIDS or cancer, which cannot be cured, at least we have medicines which will help us control them. Maybe not cure them completely, but at least we can expect 2 or 3 or 5 or 10 years more out of a diseased person. My next concept will be economic development, where I would like to concentrate on globalization. The global mass media connects people all over the world. It helps business, it helps in every way of life. I can conduct business in Iceland just because I have communication and globalization. The culture barrier has reduced, ladies and gentlemen. I can go marry a Mexican or an American or an Argentinian just because I know and I can go there, ladies and gentlemen. And I know because my parents have a broad mind, they will make me marry him or her for that matter. And coming to entrepreneurship, the Shri Mahila Griha Udyog, Richard Papad, has helped people, has helped women in the rural and urban areas, but it has empowered them, it has given them employment, it has given them economic freedom and financial freedom to run their lives, ladies and gentlemen. It is one of the most remarkable entrepreneurial initiatives by women in India, and it is identified with female empowerment. It has even had initiatives in computer education for women, ladies and gentlemen, especially in the rural areas.
Welcome home to all of you. Motion before us today is, I am happy than my forefathers. I stand against the motion. Well, to me, happiness is a personal trait, which is a complete package of emotions, which varies from contentment to intense joy. In my debate, I'm going to bring forward a contrast between the life we live today and that existed years ago when our forefathers were alive. I'm going to take up 6 major arguments, number 1 being the changed life of today. With the fast-changing life of today, people hardly have time to socialize. In fact, you know, even the closest of relatives, people barely interact. Man, being a social animal, is being deprived of this basic need, whereas earlier, families were very closely knit. Today, the challenge of conveying oneself is missing and has been replaced by social networking sites, which have made us more synthetic in our interactions. Now, how can you expect one to be happy without being able to express oneself. According to WHO statistics, one person commits suicide every 40 seconds. My second argument talks about the unhealthy lifestyle. The advent of fast food joints has made our life more dependent on junk food, which has led a whole new generation of people having diseases our forefathers never even heard of. Today, we especially talk about routines to fit our working out hours. Recreational activities are given a miss. Malnutrition, obesity and stress have become a part of our survival. This whole concept of modernization has actually gifted us a stressful, unhealthy and a very complex lifestyle. In contrast, our forefathers ate natural food, didn't depend upon the dried fruit type of drugs, and all did the illness of today. Coming to the third argument of the lost values, let me tell you, the education system today has become so commercialized that it hardly thinks of imparting societal values to children, unlike the gurukuls that existed before. It's the quantity and not the quality that matters now. World has become so competitive and selfish that, it has led to a change of priorities in life. It has become a no-tolerance zone today. Wherein earlier there was more discipline in the family, there were fewer wants which were satisfied by, working hard. Even a single earner could run a family of 5 children. But then I think, that the values that existed before are completely gone today. My next argument deals with the point of social security. Our forefathers always felt safe in their neighborhood. Doors were left unlocked. Today, we are not even clued up about our next door neighbor. Crime rates, thefts and murders have all increased. Every now and then, we hear about the murders of especially old people who are actually, by their own servant, which completely means that, a very blurred, unsafe future lies ahead of us. Next, we're going to talk about the advancements of today, which are just a partial bonus according to me. Even though technology has improved a lot, has made our life easier and given us a luxurious life, but all that has made us more sluggish, more lethargic, made us more dependent on gadgetry. Along with that, there's much unequal distribution of resources in the world today, which has amounted to slums and poverty. Modern life is full of congestion, pollution and noise. About 195 million people are unemployed. 1.4 billion who are full-time employed live on less than $2 a day. Within this world full of opportunities. Coming to my own country, as my opponents mentioned about the better medical facilities, let me tell you, about 40% of the health centers are understaffed and only 10% of our population has health insurance coverage. My last argument simply says that the only road to happiness is following the footsteps of our forefathers. Let's talk about the revival of traditional practices like yoga and meditation, which completely proves that we are not content today and restoring to these beliefs, to these traditional practices to actually revive peace.